how to accelerate your wealthy life. So the most important thing, first off, if you truly want to create that wealthy life, where you're living the life you really want, where you're able to fill your life with joy and have the time to spend how you want to do it, with whom you want to do it, where you want to do it, live and experience the things you want to experience, is the most important first step is get really clear on what the bleep you want. This is super, super important. How to be a wealthy spender. Go and watch that video, getting really clear on what you want. Because most of the time when people aren't living their greatest life is they're drifting around because they've got a drifted or a default life or even a reactive life instead of a life that's designed around knowing what they want and then focus on creating that. Know what you want and focus on bringing that in your life and strip away all the stuff that doesn't. The next real important strategy is to automate the good and to make manual the bad. What am I talking about here? In behavioral economics and behavioral science, it's shown that we'll tend to automate the things that don't serve us. And in fact, there's this big industry out there that is aimed to automate or make easier and easier, easier the choices that actually aren't going to serve you. Think of the fast food industry, that junk quick grab to fill up that, you know, that sugar need when your blood sugars have dropped. Consumer debt, there's a massive industry that wants it, makes it easier and easier and easier for you to just go into debt. All these ways that really keep you imprisoned and locked in. And so research has shown that the more you can make manual the choices around the things that aren't necessarily going to serve you, the more space you give yourself to actually have the consciousness to go, really, does this serve me or not? We've got two key parts of our brain. We've got the limbic system, which is a bit like the automated impulse response in the brain that will just react at stuff, that spend, that impulse spending, that emotionally driven spend, that grabbing of that sugar treat. And then we have the frontal cortex, this part of our brain, which is really the part that is more evolved, that has more discernment. But the challenge is the impulse part of our brain really responds super, super quick. And often we've done stuff before the conscious or more savvy part of our brain has even had a chance to catch up and connect in and even have a say in the choice that's made. And so when we can go, well, what are the things that aren't really serving me? And maybe you've spent some time looking at your spend planning, you've gone back over the last 3 or even years, years spent and go, wow, you know, I actually unconsciously spend a whole bunch of money in this and this and this area. And you go, I'm going to become more conscious about it because this is just impact spend. The way you do that is become more manual. Stop using that contactless card. You know, disconnect your credit card number from that online spending, that one-click sell. All of those automated convenience systems are designed for you to do those things unconsciously and much quicker before the savvy part of your brain can click in. So when you unlink that and you go, okay, I'm going to force myself to have to go and get my card if I want to buy that thing online, just giving yourself that space will let yourself go, do I really need this? Does it really serve me? Do I have to have this? And if so, why? And often just that space will really save you loads. This is the same in terms of your spending. I know it might seem convenient just to wave that card around for that contactless spend, but it's just making you more disconnected. So get more intimate with the choices that you need to make where maybe it's hard to make the empowered choice. And then on the other side, you want to automate as much as possible and just make easier and easier the choices that are going to serve you. So this is things like automated investment planning. Put your expand your dough automated monthly investing on autopilot. Because if you've got to manually go and do that every month, there's more likely you're going to find an excuse not to do it. Automate your saving. Automate your investing. Automate your spending. Your investing. Get together a shopping list and put that list on an online shopping site and just have it set that every month those expenses, well, those things will be bought. So you're not going into shopping center and get triggered on that. So the more you can automate things, the better. Automate your debt blitz planning so that all of those things you automate, but all the things that haven't been serving you, make more manual. Super, super important. The next thing you do to really create your wealthy life is simplify. The more you can simplify your life, the wealthier you're going to be. Now, a lot of people think simplifying is around less, around somehow settling. And we've got a society that has all started worshiping complexity, that if it's complex, it must be better. If it's got lots more buttons than everything else, even if we don't use them, then that must make it fancy. If there's an investment strategy that we don't understand at all, that's got long fancy words, ooh, that must be good. But also just in our choices, we've got hooked into believing that if we're super busy, if we've got lots going on, if we've got lots of complexity in our life or the way we manage our money and we manage our day, then that means success. But in fact, research shows over and over and over that that interwoven hurriedness, that confusion, that complexity creates in many cases actually takes us away from real wealthy, joyful living. So look at each area of your life. How can you simplify in your relationships, in your money management, just the stuff that you have around you, the choices you need to make. So simplifying is also automating things is a way of simplifying your spend decisions. You simplify by having frameworks. You also simplify by having your money rules and your relationship and for yourself. There's a great friend of mine always says, you know, any investment in complexity should actually be an investment in simplicity. And I love that, really being conscious about where do you choose to bring in more stuff, choices, decisions, spends, things in your life that really isn't going to add to you by simplifying your life, or is it just going to be another set of things for you to manage somehow? And then finally, really living a wealthy life is having clear money rules. And I recommend you come up with 10 money rules for yourself. And if you're in a relationship, also look at which of those rules you're going to apply together in a relationship. So this is about, again, automating and helping simplify your thinking. Because when you have money rules, it's not even a debate. They're absolutes, have or have nots. You'll discover that truly successful people, if you research them, will have a lot more absolutes around their rules, around less successful people. They will have real go, no-go rules in key areas of their life, around their time, around their money, around how they associate, the things they will and won't do. They've got real firm boundaries, and that's what your money rules are. So key money rule is, what is the percentage of your inflow you are going to invest? When I was creating my wealth, I invested, and one of my key money rules was that I invested a minimum of 20% of all of the income that flowed in my life. Now in Wealth Pie, I say that minimum should be 10%, but I upped that to 20%, and that's why I achieved my freedom faster. What is the percentage of your income you're going to save? I had a rule that no consumer debt. Ever. No debate, no question about it. That was a hard and fast, and is a hard and fast money rule for me. No consumer debt. I use a credit card, but it's paid off every single month. And I have rules around what I will spend on that credit card versus what I'll spend on debit cards and cash. So have rules around that. Rules around money pie. How wealth pie is about how much are you going to spend on your day-to-day living needs. What is going to be the cap and the framework that you are going to choose to live your life on? These can also be rules around, for example, the things that you're going to allow yourself to spend on without any limitation. That can also be one of your money rules. You know, now I have a rule that if I see a book, whether it's an audio version or on the bookshelf that I really want, I buy it. I don't have a debate, because learning is one of my highest values. And so by having these rules for both how you're going to manage your money, how you're going to spend it, how you're going to have conversations around it, things you will absolutely not do. One of my money rules is I absolutely do not lend money to friends and family. Full stop. one of my money rules. Now, these are my rules. It might, you will have different rules, but it's really important you know what your money rules are. So that is how you accelerate your wealthy life. Setting this framework, getting in place these elements to really support you, live and experience this amazing, juicy, wealthy life with money and assets serving you, not enslaving you. So I'm Ann Wilson. If you're watching this anywhere over than at thewealthchef.com, head on over there and share with me what are two of your money rules that you have in place that really help you get money serving and supporting you. I'd just love to know that. And remember, wealth is created by baby steps. Getting intimate with our money, giving it great leadership, and understanding it and directing it so it can serve us. Keep taking baby steps and keep having loads of fun.